Hi, Rahman Rahim. My name is Abdul Jabbar, and my topic of presentation is alginate bone dressing. This product is a category of medical textiles. The contents of my presentation are: what is bone dressing? Then classification of bone dressing, wound healing concept, introduction of alginate fibers and their manufacturing, and ultimately the manufacturing process of alginate bone dressing. What is basically a bone dressing? A bone dressing is basically an urgent use by a person for application to a bone to promote healing or to prevent further damage. Basically, when a person gets injured, the purpose of wound basically is to protect it from the environmental effects and also help to heal the wound quickly and in a better way. Now, the classification of wound dressings. The wound dressings usually fall in three categories. One are the passive dressings, whose basically function is simply to protect the wound. The second one is the interactive dressing. And the last is the bioactive dressing, which along with the protection keeps a moist environment of wound and release some substances which help or which promote the wound healing. Basically, when an injury takes place, the healing of wound takes place in three steps. One is the hemostasis, that is the clotting, which takes place immediately after the injury. The second is the granulation, which is the regeneration of new cells. And the last one is the epithelialization, which is the division and migration of cells from the wound edges to close the wound and to build a new skin layer. This epithelialization process can be controlled to increase or to decrease the wound healing. A wound which is unable to keep the moist environment, the epithelialization process will be slow, while the wound that is capable to keep the environment of the wound moist will promote the epithelialization in a better way, and those wound dressings which along with keeping the moist environment of the wound releases some substances will promote the epithelialization in a more effective way. Now, the alginate fibers. What are the alginate fibers? Alginate fibers basically consist of a natural copolymer which is usually alginic acid. And this alginic acid is composed of two monomers. One is the monuronic acid and the second is glutaronic acid. This polymer is extracted from certain species of seaweed, and the percentage or the proportion of these two acids in the polymer may vary depending on the type of species. And this change in the proportion of the acid may affect the wound healing. Now the extraction of polymer from these species. Basically, this natural polymer is extracted from the seaweed in the form of sodium alginate powder, which may contain different proportions of glucuronic acid and mononic acid. Now the manufacturing of calcium alginate fiber. Sodium alginate, which is in the form of powder, is dissolved in water to make a dope solution, which is then extruded through the spinneret into a bath containing calcium ion. In this way, solid calcium alginate is formed as a continuous filament of the required diameter. Basically, sodium alginate is soluble in water, while the calcium alginate is unsoluble. Typically, these filaments, after the precipitation, are stretched, washed, dried, and crimped before they are cut into shorter length. Now, before making these short fibers into a fabric structure, how this calcium alginate fiber helps to promote the wound healing? Basically, the wound contains a fluid which has excess of sodium ions. When this dressing is applied on the wound, calcium ions are exchanged with the sodium ions, thus forming a gel which keeps the area of the wound moist, and the calcium ions help to promote the wound healing. Basically, the alginate dressing is made in the form of non-woven. Non-woven structures have more liquid absorbing capability, bulk softness, and greater ability to manage fluid in all three dimensions. Therefore, non-woven structures for making wounds are usually preferred in the modern era. Now, the flow chart of this for manufacturing of this non-woven structure consists of opening the fiber. The second one is the carding. Third one is the web formation. Then bonding of the fibers by some mechanical means, and last one is the sterilization and packing. This is the representation of an opening line. This is the second step, which is carding. Basically, for manufacturing of non-woven fabric, we didn't require the intensive opening of the fibers, which is usually used for cotton or other similar type of fibers. This flat stripping has intensive action on the fiber, while the roller stripping has a gentle and not an intensive opening of the fiber. Therefore, for making non-woven fabrics, we usually prefer roller stripping carding. After the carding of the alginate fiber, we make the web either by cross-lapping or by parallel-lapping. Either of both techniques can be used. After the web formation, we impart the strength to the web by entangling the fibers with each other, and the mechanical bonding technique called the needle punching is used for bonding the web. This is the representation of a normal needle punching process. After that, the stabilization and packing is done, and the finished alginate bond dressing is ready for use for any kind of purpose.